I don't condemn them at all, because if somebody believes the sun is the source of life, they have a reason. What I see nowadays, the more you see, maybe because no sun, no life, isn't it? That's what they say. So people say God, okay, this religion says God is like that, another say like this, then you put it this way.
When I bring your mom into it, now it's personal. You know, I understand. And you know, listen to that, I don't class you as one of them. What means? I know you respect the moms. I know you match with the moms. I know you know where we come from when it comes to our moms. I know you know that. You're not a dumb person, you understand? So by your standards, what kind of thing did I do?
Why are you coming to tell me that? Whatever he did, he said
You just said it.
Listen, what are you going to do to me, bro? Am I supposed to be like,
we can hear your voice. Please, you're going to talk to you've got people here.
Yeah, what are you saying?
I was disturbed what I saw.
Yeah.
Because what I saw was that you were ganging up on him.
Ganging up? How? Yeah. How did he get ganged up?
Are you holding him and then Matthew punching him in his face?
I appreciate it, but hold on. You had Matthew hitting him. You had that. You were holding him.
You had to kick him on the floor.
If you hit that guy,
one guy kick him on the floor.
Should have been him and him having a fight.
So what do you want me to say about it? Did I ask anyone to do anything? What do you want me to say about it? People are going to react how they're going to react. I got no control over it.
No.
So why are you coming to tell me what?
What I'm coming to tell you is that...
Come on, man. I'm speaking real, bro.
That's unacceptable behaviour, bro.
What do you mean unacceptable? Who says the rule
book? Number one...
Have you got a rule book for me?
It's your own principle.
Come on, man. Behave, man. Behave. Have you got a rule book for me? Have you got a rule book for me?
No, but that's what you said.
Have you got a rule book for me?
Yeah, but that's what you're... That's your rules. That's all you... That's your rules, though. You said that's acceptable.
I don't go by your rules.
No, but you said your rules.
You said
that's acceptable. That's what you said.
You understand? Here comes the man. Here comes the man. Bro, Matthew, bro. Bro, you're 50 years old, son. 50 years old, man. Bro, seriously.
Where's the best? Right, so what have you come for?
You think
what have you come for? You're just doing this sneakiness, bro. You're calling man 50 and that's dumb, bro.
What was dumb? What is it dumb? We can't accept that. We can't accept that behavior.
You can't accept that behavior. So what are you going to do?
What are you going to do? Okay, how about this? How about
me
down fight?
Yeah,
let's go
in
the corner.
What are you doing there?
again.
What's going on?
Don't do it! Come back. Shut up, man.
Why are you doing that?
Well, you seem to be in the rush, bro.
You're the 101. We go to the club
right
now.
We never like you. You see what I mean? Come on, let's go 101.
You want to pick you up? He wants to fight people that are smaller than him, bro.
Sorry, no, no, no. Hold on.
He punched this guy called Oz, who was a mentally disturbed.
Did he do that?
Yeah, knocked him out. Number two, he pushed Talha, which is like half his weight. Number three, he's coming now pushing Muslims from one
end. No, we protected him. Who did he push?
I said he pushed Talha, number one, yeah? He pushed that, it's on the thing. Number two, yeah, he punched this guy outside of McDonald's who was on his side.
I know about
number three, he come in and hold this guy and this other guy, Maku, with the 501 okay,
so conversation.
So hold on.
That's the conversation.
Let's finish. This guy, yeah, if he wants to see that he's a big man when it comes to these small lightweights and disabled people, then how about you go do one on one?
I said, with you.
And I said to him, legal as well. And by the way, let me tell you something that you didn't know. Let me tell you a secret. He came to me.
Let him finish.
We have avenues here in this country. I'm really sorry, but this individual, he came to me one time in private, yeah, and Raspect was there, and he's the witness. He came to me, he goes, out of nowhere, he came and said, do you want to fight me? Out of nowhere, I was by myself. I said, oh, well, you want to fight me? He said, yeah. I said, okay, let's do it in a legal way, because in Speaker's Corner, it's not the place or the time.
Exactly.
So I took Leon's number.
Who's that individual you're talking about? What are you talking about?
Let me explain.
Well, let him finish.
Why no, you but he said this individual. Who?
He would say, let him finish.
I don't have his number. I've got Raspect's number, I got Leon's number. So I tried to get his number to make this work. So I said to him, okay, if you really want to do this, there's legal ways you can do it, and so on and so forth. So I took Leon's number. I said, Leon, tell him this is where we can do it. Because there's certain rules of MMA, semi-pro, whatever. You've got to be registered to a club. So I said, no problem. Either that or you go to a club and spar.
If you guys want to fight, that's fine. Now, if you guys want to go to a gym,
we can organize all of that.
It makes sense.
Bro, let me tell you something. When he came to me, what did he do, Leon? Leon's a witness. He said, I'm not really on it or whatever, yeah?
Okay.
So he didn't want to continue with that. So why is it the case now with a heavyweight?
All I remember that time there, that's when everybody was offering.
Okay. But what did he do? He didn't want to continue with it. Did he follow it through? No, he didn't. So the point is this, when it comes to heavyweights that can give him a hard time, he's not doing it. But when it comes to lightweights, Muslims, vulnerable individuals, disabled people, he'll do it. So we're saying no more of that. Sorry to say. If you want to act like a big man, act with a big man like a big man.
100%.
Act with a big man 100%. Like a big man.
Allahu Akbar.
Yeah, no, that's how it is. I'm sorry. Muslims are not weak. By the way, one more thing. Sorry. And I'll make it clear now. If you want to fight me, let's go tomorrow. Put on live. It'll be in an MMA thing. I got the sparring class. Let's do a few rounds.
He's here to place the fight. Hold on. You're smart. He's here to place.
Raven, please don't misrepresent me.
Let me say this, and then you say that.
Raven, let me just let me, one
you,
more thing.
You've got 5 minutes, bro. Let me speak for one. Yeah, you can speak for another one. Yeah? It's here the place to fight. Right?
I never said it was.
So, when we're here, if you want to arrange a fight, you can do peacefully. Hold on, because I spent my life.
He didn't want to do it peacefully.
I spent my life trying to stop people getting stabbed and killed and so forth, right? So, I'm here. When the hype is here, people get stabbed and hype.
So, Raven, where were you when they were beating up this brother?
I wasn't there. I was in Barbados. Getting my hands on.
No, bro.
Violence is wrong, guys. Violence is wrong. You don't want to be fighting each other.
Sorry to say.
Come on, man.
When these Muslims get beaten up in the park, one guy got spat in the face. Where's the brother? The Somalian brother got spat in the face. Yeah? Number one. Number two. The brother got smacked in the face of a mushaf of a Quran by Bob the Builder. Yeah. Number three. Now we're getting a Muslim guy getting held and beaten up yeah, rushed in front of everyone, and there's no political consequences, no, what do you call it, law consequences whatsoever. Yeah, we're not going to accept that, bro. Let's take this guy, let's at least get our honor back. This guy, he wants to really fight, let's do it in a legal way.
Yeah.
What I said to him, let's have a legal, I want to fight you legally. Right. That's what I said to him. After that, everyone started acting wherever they acted. I didn't say to him, let's fight you illegally, let's fight now.
What's my point?
I didn't say that.
Right.
Look on the fat camera.
It's very important, my point is very important.
Yeah, you agree with
about saving lives, right? So what's my point?
So if you're saving lives, where were you, brother, when they were getting beaten up?
I told you, I was in Barbados getting my hands twisted. What's wrong?
No, so
I wasn't in the country.
Okay, say about it. What do you want to say about it now?
It's like this, right? Here.
No. What do you want to say about the guys getting beaten up?
Any form of fighting.
No.
It's not allowed.
Raven, sorry. Now you're just being ridiculous.
Raven,
you're being ridiculous, Raven.
What do you want me to do? No. Tell me the word you want me to say to make you happy.
No.
Tell me the word you want me to say to make you happy.
First of all, do you condone or condemn the fact that this guy, his mum was brought into the equation?
100%.
What? Condemn it?
Yeah, of course I'm.
You condemn. Number two.
I condemn.
When they were getting hit, hold on. When this guy, when he was standing up.
Yeah. You can tell me any scenario.
Let me finish.
If someone's getting hit, their mum's
don't generalize it. You're trying to generalize it. Raven, you're trying to generalize it. I'm trying to specify it. Yeah, last week...
I'll skip it. I condemn it.
What do you condemn? What part?
I condemn any form of violence.
No, don't say any.
Yeah.
No, I'm not saying any. Listen. I'm saying the brother was getting held and the other one was punching him.
Okay. That's not any form of violence.
Okay, I condemn. That's rushing, get someone getting
held. But he says condemning it.
What do you mean?
He doesn't agree with it.
See, I don't have this dynamic of black Muslim, happy, good.
I didn't say something about black Muslim.
Because I'm saying, right?
So if you say, I've never said that.
I'm saying, in the park, all forms of violence is
no problem. I mean, you agree with that,
bro.
So why is there no consequences when Muslims get beaten up in the park?
100%. Well, I don't know.
Why is there no consequences for that?
Well, who am I? I'm not the mayor of Muslims.
Okay, so why is this guy, I think he's a big man with little men?
Okay, I don't know.
He's outside the park.
So why is he a coward with big men?
But I'm saying when we are here.
So do you think he's a coward?
No,
he's 100% a coward.
I don't name call.
Yeah, he's a coward.
I don't name call.
No, sir.
I don't name call.
Raven, sorry.
I don't name call you.
No.
So I don't
me. I'm not. It's me and you. I'm not calling you a coward.
I'm saying,
what do you consider someone who in a group?
No.
He's holding him like that, he's being crucified, and the other one is punching him.
I don't name call.
Violent is wrong. Violent is wrong, guys.
That will happen.
They're away from me.
They come here like nothing's gonna happen to him. There's no consequence.
So first of all, I've seen the video, right? I condemn it all. But what I'm saying is, it isn't like a straight cut thing. All right. First of all, name calling was done, I'm the first to say, as people can back up, you do not name call him. If we're having a debate,
you're not specifying. You're keeping it general. Jedi.
What do you want me to do?
No.
Do you want me to arrest Jedi?
No. I'm saying to you.
Who am I, Jedi's keeper?
No. You're coming here representing him.
No. I'm here stopping violence.
Bro, I was protecting him.
Okay. Well, like I said.
No, hold on. That brother there with the helmet, whatever. I don't know. Some guy was gonna come for him. I put him aside.
Okay.
I protected Jedi today.
10 points for that.
No, not 10 points. That's 100 points.
Okay, well, I don't give out that.
Let's see how many points.
Man wants a full sentence.
Why does he want to fight a big man? Why does he always want to fight small men?
Listen,
right? Can't answer that question. He's not representing.
Well, he's not representing Jedi.
Why does he want to fight small lightweights?
He's representing non-violence.
A heavyweight fights a lightweight.
I'm saying this, right?
And one
I'm okay with fighting, right? If you want to pick a place outside, I'm saying here we can't have the whole argue about this.
No problem.
Because we have hype men, and hype men are people that come down. They don't come week to week, and on that day they get hyped, they start pulling out knives, start doing stuff.
There's no knives here, bro.
Okay, no, well, I'm telling
well, that
you.
He had a knife.
He had a knife.
I got a punch.
Cool.